There are three assumptions we use in instrumental variables analysis. Two of them, the exclusion restriction and the exogeneity assumption, are non-refutable. That means that even with infinitely large sample sizes, a huge amount of data, you could never tell if they were correct or not. So what are we going to do? Well, to figure out if we believe them or not, or whether they're credible, we have to do that without the data itself. So instead, we have to use our qualitative knowledge and understanding of the context of the application to argue that they hold in your example. Now, this is often a really contentious part of any instrumental variables analysis, precisely because you can't use the data itself to back up your claims. So researchers might disagree about whether the assumption holds or not, and you just can't disprove either one of them. Now, this is a common theme in doing causal inference with observational data. At some point, we're ultimately going to have to make a non-refutable assumption if we're going to get at causality. That's why randomized experiments and true natural experiments are so widely acclaimed, because they require so few assumptions to get at causal effects. Now, although don't forget, we talked about a few caveats to that, but for the most part, experiments don't require a lot of assumptions. Unlike instrumental variables, where we need these three assumptions, exclusion, relevance, and exogeneity. Now, the relevance condition, it actually is refutable. You can use the data to test whether that assumption holds. Why is that? Well, basically, assuming the exogeneity assumption, we have a randomized experiment for the effect of the instrument on the treatment. So we can just learn causal effects using our experimental analysis and then check, is that causal effect zero or not? This is often called doing a first stage regression or looking at the first stage effect of the instrument on the treatment. So there are three assumptions needed in instrumental variables analysis. The relevance assumption you can test with your data. The exclusion restriction and the exogeneity assumption you can. You're going to have to use qualitative knowledge to argue that they hold.